A very good evening and a warm welcome to all our esteemed guests and to dear learners. I'm Dr. Ria Tukral from Radaropus by BGenRx, and we are here today to discuss a very interesting topic, using eliminative rubrics to reach the minimum with Dr. Chakshu Mishra. We have Dr. Mishra live with us right now. But before we go ahead with this webinar, most of you already know about Radaropus software, but for those who don't, let me quickly give you an overview. So allow me to quickly tell you a little about Radaropus homeopathic software. So Radaropus homeopathic software is a name that we all are familiar with. It has an all-in-one revolutionary interface offering repository, materia medica, and the patient files on one single simple platform. It comes enriched with more than 30 repositories, including synthesis repository, which is highly reliable and flexible enough to suit your needs. With Radaropus, you will have access to 1500 plus books and volumes in the references section, which is the largest collection among all the softwares available. The WinChip patient management tool helps you to keep track of your patients, consultations, pathology, etc., and helps you to extract information very easily. There are a number of concepts and families for you to choose from to help in your case analysis. You can even let Dr. George Witholkart help you in solving your case with his expert system. So you see why Radaropus is the number one choice. It is fast, it is simple, flexible, reliable, and authentic. For Radaropus users, we conduct free webinars, quizzes every week. We provide technical guidance, data protection, new updates, and free notes as well. For those who are interested, Radaropus comes in these 5 packages. You can see the prices on your screen. For more information on each package, please visit our website, www.bgenrx.com. We do have a no-cost EMI offer available for you, where you can pay an advance amount followed by 6 installments for next 6 months. You can see the advance amount you'll have to pay for each package on your screen. So do contact us at the given numbers, or you can mail us as well. I'm providing you the mail ID and contact number in the chat as well in a few minutes. So if you still have doubts, you can always experience the software for free before buying it. Simply download the free demo version available on our website, www.bgenrx.com, in the free demo page. So thank you so much for listening. That's all about Radaropus. Coming back to this webinar, Dr. Chakshu Mishra, can we please have you here with us? Please come live for our audience.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for having me here.
It's a pleasure, sir. So everybody, we have Dr. Mishra right here with us. Dr. Chakshu Mishra, he is an academician, a physician, and a counseling psychologist. He is an assistant professor in Chandola Homeopathic Medical College, and he has even won the Youth Icon Award by Homeo Youth Congress in 2016. He is also a life member of Ozone Forum of India, Liga LMHI, and IIHP. Thank you so much, sir, for being here with us. We are very happy to have you here with us.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was a pleasure. It's a pleasure of having a session with Radar. So I hope and I aim to train a few things which are very practical and result oriented in a day-to-day practice. So thank you, ma'am.
Before I hand over to you, let me quickly explain our learners how this interface works so that we can start with your lecture immediately. So on the right-hand side panel of your screen, you have a short chat box. You may type your question or whatever message you have for Dr. Chakshu Mishra right there and press the button next to it to send it to us. I request you all to send your questions only after the lecture is over, as that might disturb him and we wouldn't want that. So that's it for me. So without wasting any more time, let's start learning. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So hello, everyone. And today's session is going to be really interesting because I have made it very easy to understand. And moreover, I'm trying to make it more result oriented in day-to-day practice. So let's start with the session. So here we go. So today's topic will be using eliminative rubrics to reach simulimum. You see, elimination method of reportization is a known type of reportization method. But the problem is that most of the people don't use it more often. And in fact, most of the people don't use repository in day-to-day practice. So if you say we homeopaths have divided ourselves among the four groups. Number one are the keynote prescribers who have no interest in repository. They are plain material medical prescribers. And I have, you can see it, I respect them well. But if you talk about the other group, then they are firm believers in philosophy of prescribing using the repository. The third one is that they still believe in symptom similarity, but in order to give results, they have started prescribing either keynotes or therapeutically. And the last is that those are the newcomers who don't want to waste their time in reporterization, and their only aim is to give results in order to flourish their clinic. So it is very much important to understand that repertory and reporterization, if you make them a part of your daily practice, then it's going to help you a lot. So in today's session, I am going to teach you, and I'm going to discuss the elimination method in a practical way so that we can get maximum results in our clinical practice on a daily basis. So what I am going to discuss is a brief about eliminative symptoms or rubrics, then how to select an eliminative rubric, how to use radar opus for reporterization. If we want to use intensities and eliminative rubrics together, then is it feasible or not? Then preferred practical or result-oriented method. And lastly will be some practical examples. So let's talk about the elimination process of reporterization. As we all know, it was introduced by Dr. M.L. Tyler, and she was a renowned homeopath. So what she basically said was that in order to prescribe through repertory, we need to go through reporterization, but in order to save our time and quickly come to simulimum, we need to have a process of elimination of most similar remedies which we get through reporterization. So what we do in this process is that we select the most important or stress symptom of the person without which we cannot think of prescription. It was previously preferred to be a general symptom. Now, the symptom will be placed on the top. This is how we used to do it before. When we select the symptom and reporterize, we consider only those medicines which cover the first and the top symptom. So this whole process, which I'm just telling you right now, is the manual process of reporterization. So if we take a few more symptoms, the process remains the same. The result will keep on narrowing down. So it is rather important to choose the symptoms wisely. And yes, it is very much important to have a proper evaluation of the totality which you have got after the case. Now, the point is, what is an eliminative symptom? So you see, the bookish language says that those symptoms which help to eliminate some unimportant medicines to facilitate the selection of simulimum is an eliminative symptom. But if you further categorize it, it will be that those symptoms which can be used to remove those medicines which are not needed for the patient and brings up only the required ones. Or moreover, those symptoms which are actually preferred by the physician to bring into the limelight of the case for a better simulimum of selection. If you come to the history, you'll find that not even Dr. M.L. Tyler, Dr. Kent himself has also emphasized on using those eliminative symptoms in chronic cases. In fact, Dr. Elizabeth Wright has mentioned the symptomatology in the way of common symptoms, mentals, generals, objectives, pathological, particulars, and lastly, eliminative symptom, giving emphasis upon the importance of eliminative symptom in the selection of a similar remedy. So let's talk about the practical explanation of an eliminative symptom. What is an actual practical explanation? So if you see, there are always some symptoms which are stressed by the patient. That means if a patient is coming to your clinic, he's explaining you the symptoms, he's telling you about his complaints, there will be always one or two symptoms which he'll be laying stress on every time. So if a physician wants a final selection of report of a remedy, then reporterization result should be focused on that stressed symptom. Now, we have different kinds of prescribers in homeopathy. For example, if you are following any school of homeopathic medicine, then you'll be able to understand that some prefer on mental generals, while others prefer on complete symptoms. But it is very much important for a physician, whether it be an experienced physician or it be a younger physician, or very new to the community. So you need to understand that we are practicing in order to give results to our patients. So at least our prescriptions should be result oriented. Moreover, it should also contain the basic minimum explanation of homeopathy. That means we should find a remedy which should be similar to the case, as well as which should be result oriented for the case. So in order to achieve that, you see, if we are trying to just go to the simillimum, it might not give the expected results as early as possible. So if a physician wants to utilize that particular symptom, which is stressed, which is more lied upon by the patient, then you will have to choose it as an eliminative symptom. And if you are using that stress symptom as an eliminative, then you'll get more result oriented prescription. So what will be the key points? How you will select an eliminative symptom? This is very much important to understand, and every point matters. So the point one is, it should be just one symptom, but if required, more than three symptoms. You see, it is not at all a rule, but still, if you want to get good results, at least you should try to have one symptom, but not more than three symptoms. Otherwise, there will be fluctuations in getting the result. Then secondly, a single eliminative symptom should always be a general symptom. It is very much important, because you need to find a remedy which is homeopathically or which is very similar to the case. Now, if the stress symptom of the patient is a particular, then it should include a clear and reconfirmed modality. Moreover, if it is needed to select more than one eliminative symptom, then the other symptoms should be generals along with a clear diagnostic symptom. So you see, nowadays, we young homeopaths have been always trying to focus upon the diagnosis. So you need to have, if you want to have more than one eliminative symptom, then the first one should be a general, no doubt. But if you are choosing two more, then other one should also be a general. It can be one mental general, one physical general, and along with a clear diagnostic symptom. It is always recommended to keep an eye on the sources of medicines mentioned along with diagnostic rubric. It is very much important. If you are using many modern repertories, for example, Murphy's, for example, synthesis, or if even you are using any other modern repertory, you need to make sure that the source of medicine mentioned in the diagnostic rubric should be as broad as possible. Now, never alone select a diagnostic rubric or symptom as an eliminative rubric. Yes, it is important that you should never alone select a diagnostic rubric. Now, here there is a caution, and the caution is that if you have come to a diagnosis and that diagnosis contains very small group of remedies, for example, if it contains more than 20 remedies and every remedy which is mentioned in that rubric is somehow very much confirmed and it has very authentic sources for that, then you can still choose that diagnostic rubric. And I'll show you how in the examples. Now, yes, if you are using elimination method, then there are positive aspects as well as negative aspects. The first positive aspect is that it is always a result-oriented prescription. Secondly, it resolves confusion while selection among similar remedies obtained after reporterization, and it is the most important positive aspect. Because whenever you are reporterizing, we always get two or three remedies which are very much clear, similar to each other. Then we have to get back to Materia Medica in order to confirm it. But somehow, if you have something, if you have a method in order to just have some have some clear differentiation among them, then you will have that elimination method is very much great in order to get those results. Now, the third point is that once you learn how to select an elimination symptom or eliminating symptom while working out a case, it will require less time to obtain a remedy, of course, but you will have to practice it once, twice, again and again. And once you are very much familiar with the elimination method, then obviously you'll get very less time in order to obtain the results. Now, the negative aspects. So there are always negative and positive aspects. So the negative aspect is that selection cannot be quick. That means on the first visit, when a patient is visiting you to your clinic, never utilize the elimination method at once. At least give a first or second follow-up for the patient in order to come to a conclusion, or you just sit back at your clinic and just try to recapitulate what were those important points which he was trying to stress on. And if you find that, yes, there is a symptom which was very important, then you can choose it as an eliminating symptom. Secondly, that selection of only pathological symptoms also degrades the true homeopathic aspects. If you have not taken the case properly, you are just utilizing the pathological symptoms along with the particulars, then you will not get proper results. A stress symptom, if not analyzed and reconfirmed, may also yield improper results, and the multiple eliminative symptoms will also degrade the true essence of the case. So it is always recommended to have at least a minimum of 3 eliminative rubrics, not more than that. Okay, now coming to the selection of eliminative rubrics in day-to-day practice. You see, if you are using one eliminative rubric at a time, it should be the most characteristic and prominently observed symptom of the patient. If you are having 2 eliminative rubrics, then the first should be the most pronounced modality, and the second should be a strong modality or a strong mental symptom. Third, if you are using pathological or diagnostic symptoms as eliminative, then since in any remedy in the materia medica may be indicated to the case, so you need to understand that diagnostic rubrics are sometimes, they contain very less number of remedies. So the diagnostic rubric should be very particular. And moreover, if you are having a diagnostic rubric, you should always search for the source of medicines mentioned with the diagnostic rubrics. Now, different types of symptoms which can be taken up as eliminative. You see, I feel like that people are getting bored, but it is very much important to understand the basics first. Now, if you talk about the symptoms which can be taken up as eliminative, then the first should be the general symptom, which should be preferably a physical general and with details, especially a modality. If you are opting a mental general as an eliminative symptom, then it should not be any usual reaction of the patient. I have seen many of the newcomers, when they are taking up cases, when they are explaining, or even when they are discussing cases with each other, they are opting mental generals on just basis of the word which is mentioned in the repertory. For example, if absent-minded is written over there, if confusion is written over there, then you just cannot take that mental general. You need to be very sure that it is a usual reaction of the patient. Now, the third is, a conditional usual reaction is always misleading. You need to keep in mind, if a mental general is taken up in any case, then a usual reaction of patient, which can be a reaction of anybody in that condition, it is always misleading. Now, if you are choosing a diagnostic rubric, you should always keep a note of the sources of medicines. I have already discussed that before. If you are choosing a particular symptom, it is very much easier so that we can utilize it as a complete symptom with more details. Any symptom which is more stressed, yeah, which is more complained by the patient, must be thoroughly verified at least thrice. If you cannot verify it at least thrice, at least you can verify it with the people accompanying the patient or with anybody in the family who is very close to the patient. In this way, the most stressed or most complained symptom can be verified again and again. There are cautions. Number one is, if evaluation of symptom is not properly practiced, the method will prove disastrous. This is very much important to understand. You need to evaluate the symptoms in order to get the best results out from the elimination method. The hierarchy of symptoms should be adequately accurate. This is very much important. Now, there is always a confusion when you talk about the hierarchy, because maximum of the practitioners, they utilize hierarchy along with the intensities. So I'll explain it to you why we should not utilize intensities with the hierarchy. If there is a pre-selected symptom or a rubric and it has very few symptoms, then it will be off without any help. Moreover, if the sources of medicines which are mentioned in rubrics are not authentic, most of the times the medicines are authentic, but the point is that some sources are not authentic. So you need to find those sources. The medicines might yield the results, but if the sources from which the medicines are coming, if those sources are not accurate, they have not properly gained those results, then it will basically prove disastrous for your future results. Now, I'll come to the point of radar opus, how you can use the method of elimination with radar opus. You see, this is a case of trigeminal neuralgia. Now, from this point onwards, it is going to be a very interesting topic for all of you. This is a case of trigeminal neuralgia where I got to see a patient of about for 50 years. You see, I have divided the symptoms. I have evaluated the symptoms very properly into mental generals, physical generals, and particulars. Now you just see that here, the face pain, nerves, trigeminal neuralgia. Now this symptom is basically a pathological or a diagnostic symptom. If you go to synthesis repertory, you will find that maximum repertories mentioned with this rubric are authentic. They have very authentic sources. Now, in these cases, if you see in just this case, you find arsenic, then you find sepia, you find belladonna, you find phosphorus, many, many remedies, and maximum remedies are very close to each other. If you are trying to prescribe on similimum, then if this is the case, this is the same case of trigeminal neuralgia. In the previous case, you can see that the mental symptoms were very limited. There were very limited physical symptoms. And the particulars were well taken. Now, if this is the case where there are so many mental symptoms, where there is anxiety of health, there is anxiety of being alone, he is discontented, he is sensitive to external impressions because trigeminal neuralgia is a very painful condition. He's angry at trifles, he's irritable, consolation is aggravating him, he's weeping. The weeping is that a patient is weeping, he cannot weep, although he's sad. So if you have these many mental symptoms, and these symptoms are basically the reaction of the patient along with a diagnostic rubric, and then you'll find that in this case, sepia, arsenic, and nitramute, they are coming very similar to each other. You see, in the last slide, there are a number of remedies. Here also, arsenic, sepia, belladonna, phosphorus, nitramute, pulsatilla. So these were the top leading remedies. In the next case, when there were so many mentals, the nitramute jumped up to the third position from sixth or from fifth position. Now, here we will use the elimination method where I utilize a very important mental symptom of the patient, which was that he is sensitive to all external impressions. Now, you will not find many patients with this particular rubric. But yes, if you have come to a conclusion, if you have thoroughly verified it from the nearby or from the acquaintances, you'll find that yes, the patient, this symptom, that he's sensitive to external impression, if it is very much correct, then you will find that arsenic and nitramur are very close to each other. I'll switch back to slides again. In the first slide, you will find nitramur to be in the fifth position here, along with arsenic, sepia, belladonna, phosphorus, nitramur. Now, when we have taken so many mentals and we utilize the method of elimination with the major rubric in this case, we got natremur here in the second rank from the fifth. Now, in the next case, I utilized the very, very peculiar mental symptom along with the diagnostic symptom. Why? Because I wanted to give results to the patient. Now the problem was trigeminal neuralgia, a painful condition. The patient wanted to have the results as quick as possible. The patient is very much irritable. He is very much he's angry at trifles. So in this case, a sensitive patient and who is suffering from trigeminal neuralgia, if we are using these two major rubrics as eliminative, we get arsenic, belladonna, phosphorus as the leading remedies in the group. We were getting arsenic before also. It is not that we were not getting arsenic. We were getting arsenic previously in every case, right? It was the same case. In every condition, we were getting arsenic. For example, when we had so many mentals, we got arsenic in the second rank. Then when we utilized the elimination method with sensitivity as a top leading eliminative rubric, then we got arsenic in the top along with natrium uraticum. But natrium-ur was not close to the group when we are trying to give a result-oriented prescription. So how can you give a result-oriented prescription when you have utilized a pathological rubric or a diagnostic rubric along with the general rubric? So in this case, the arsenic is the leading remedy along with belladonna, phosphorus, and nux vomica as well. So if in case in future, arsenic, you have prescribed arsenic has yielded its results, the results are vanished. Now you want to further go into the case, you want a follow-up in the second prescription, you want to change the remedy or whatever you want to do, you can have all of this with this prescription, with this reporterization. And if you are again re-reporterizing the case, you'll again get similar results with what we have achieved right now. Okay. Now, another question was that if you are trying to use intensities and eliminative rubrics together, what will happen? Now, you see, in the very same case of trigeminal neuralgia, there were three symptoms which were very much stressed upon by patient, and there were high intensity. The first was anxiety. He was very much anxious about his own health. He was very much angry about in at very you know at very triples. Then he was very much irritable. Whenever he was spoken to, he was very much irritable. So yes, the intensity of these rubrics were really high. Now what we did was I utilized all these three rubrics along with higher intensities of plus three. As you can see, there are three plus categories. And after taking all these in the intensity of three, I utilized the elimination method. Right? I chose sensitivity to all external impressions and I chose trigeminal neuralgia. Now, when I'm utilizing intensities and when I'm utilizing elimination method together, you'll see now arsenic, nux vomica, belladonna, phosphorus. The remedies will remain the same. The only point is that nux vomica has come up to the second rank just because that we have taken all these symptoms as high in intensity, the all these three symptoms. Now, this creates confusion. The leading remedy, arsenic, will remain as such, but whatever remedies you are getting at the back end on the rank of second, third, or fourth, then this will create a confusion what to choose from. Now, the point is, at the end of the day, you will have to choose the remedy from the after having a conversation with Materia Medica, after taking consent from Materia Medica. But this will create a confusion among you. So it is always advisable not to use intensities along with the elimination method. What you got to do is you always, if you are trying to use elimination method, keep all the intensities to one. This is the most important thing. Never choose the intensities along with eliminative method. Raising the intensities means that you are stressing upon the importance of a symptom. Here, with the eliminative method, we utilize only most stressed or most peculiar, or in absence of both, most important pathological symptom. That means if you are utilizing eliminative method, first priority should be the most stressed symptom or the most peculiar symptom. Or if in case you are not getting any of the two, you need to have a good or a very important pathological or diagnostic rubric. The essence of the case is always preserved with eliminative method of prioritization if the symptoms are chosen wisely. Now, the preferred practical and result-oriented method for selection of remedy. This is was what I was trying to focus on throughout my webinar today. So what to do? While you are making the totality of symptoms and you are categorizing it under three heads, namely presenting complaints, mental generals, and physical generals. This is what you are going to do whenever you have taken a case. So this is the evaluation. After evaluation, you have to mark the most stressed or most complained symptom of the patient, along with the most peculiar symptoms.
So what you have done is, in the initial stages, we have taken up a case. We have basically evaluated and divided the symptoms as presenting complaint, mental generals, and physical generals. Now, secondly, what we have done is we have marked the most stressed or most complaint symptom of the patient along with the most peculiar symptoms, and then we have reporterized the case. After reporterizing, the marking is just, we have to just make a note of that stress symptom. After reporterization, we'll have to search for the evident pathological rubric in the report. We have got a result here. Now we have already got a pathological rubric in the repository. Now again, we'll add that pathological rubric along with the presenting complaint, mental generals, and physical generals, and then we will re-reporterize the case. Now, after this reporterization, the result which we'll get will obviously have many similar remedies. Now, what we got to do is, firstly, we need to mark a general rubric as an eliminative rubric. Now, this is very much important that the first selection of the rubric as eliminative should be a general rubric. After taking this as eliminative, we'll again re-reporterize the case. Again, if we are getting the result, if we are finding that it is similar, then we'll again use a presenting complaint with a clear modality and a pathological rubric as eliminative. Now, first priority is a general rubric. Second will be a rubric which is a presenting complaint, which is having a clear modality. And the third will be a pathological rubric if available and if it is having the medicines which are having clear sources. After re-reporterization of the case, the result which we will obtain will basically be homeopathic in nature, and it will give the results similar to therapeutic prescription. Now, what is the reason that maximum of the doctors which are now in practice, they are utilizing therapeutic prescriptions? The reason being that they want to get results as early as possible. So you cannot just make sure, you cannot just remove the homeopathic style of prescription if you are utilizing homeopathic medicines. This is very much important. You cannot lose the basics. So in order to prescribe a remedy which should give you the results, at least you can reporterize the case, you can utilize the method of elimination in order to get those medicines which are homeopathically similar as well as they are therapeutically efficient for the case. So in this way, the results will obviously be much more better than the therapeutic prescriptions. Now, coming to examples. The first case is where three eliminative symptoms were taken. Now, this is going to be interesting. This is a case of chronic stomatitis because of NCGS. I have utilized this case in my last webinar somewhere else, where I talked about non-celiac gluten sensitivity. Now, you see, this patient was suffering from non-celiac gluten sensitivity, and the major complaint was chronic stomatitis. Now you can see a number of symptoms here. Now these are the mental symptoms, these are the physical general, mental generals, physical generals, and lastly in the third clip, in the clipboard 3, we have the major particulars. Now you see in the particulars, the rubrics which are mentioned are mouth aphthous tongue, mouth pain, tongue burning, mouth sensitive tongue, the tongue was bleeding, and there was discoloration of tongue. Let me make you clear about the case, that this was a case of non-celiac gluten sensitivity. The patient was suffering from NCGS since last 17 to 18 years. She was not able to eat properly since last 10 years because the tongue was very much sensitive. The tongue was painful. There was bleeding from the tongue. Every time the patient was trying to eat proper food, she could not eat it. And moreover, after that pain, she was suffering from that constipation, abdominal complaints as flatulence, and then pain in rectum as well. So there were a number of complaints here. I was trying to find out a most similar remedy for the case, which was homeopathically similar, but at the end, it should give results to the patient as early as possible. So what I did in this case was, I utilized those symptoms which were very important. As I mentioned before, the first symptom should be a general symptom. So in this case, the most important symptom was loathing of life. So I utilized loathing of life. I utilized thirst, which was unquenchable for the case. She was having burning
burning sensation on the tongue. The tongue was painful. She was not able to move the tongue most of the times, and she had unquenchable thirst every time. So in this case, when I utilized all these three symptoms, the first was a mental general, that was loathing of life. Second was a physical general, that was thirst was unquenchable. And the third was a presenting complaint, which was that the tongue was very much sensitive. So when I took all these symptoms as eliminative, you can see the result. Previously, in this slide, you can see I have a number of remedies when I have so many symptoms in my clipboards. And when I utilize the method of elimination wisely, the result just shortened up to three remedies. The first one was Merksol, second was Datramute, and third was nitric acid. So you see, if you are trying to utilize the method of elimination, in such cases, you will basically understand the value of elimination method. Now, everybody has a habit of reporterizing a case if you are using repertory, of course. And every time, whenever you are utilizing a repertory, you'll get so many results which are similar to your case. But at the end, you want to have only those remedies which should give you results. So if you are utilizing symptoms wisely, you'll get the results as short as possible. Okay. Now coming back to case 2. Now here in this case 2, where I have taken only a diagnostic rubric as an eliminative rubric. I told you before not to choose a diagnostic rubric, but there was a caution that the diagnostic rubric should have those medicines which have authentic sources. Now this is a case 2 where we have a case of left-sided fibroadenoma in a female of 35 years of age. I had so many symptoms, that chest tumors, anger, irritability, the mental generals, then I had the physical generals, right, and other symptoms as well. So these all symptoms were reporterized. We came to a conclusion of phosphorus, conium, nux vomica, pulsatilla, belladonna, natremute. So these all medicines were there when we were reporterizing this case. Now, whenever you have very, very limited number of symptoms or very limited number of rubrics, then at the end of the day, you will have to find a rubric which is diagnostically sound. So I utilized chest tumors meme as a diagnostic rubric for the case. And then the result got shortened to a very less number of remedies, which were similar homeopathically to the case. Coming back to the last slide, you can see there were so many remedies. There were so many remedies which were close to the case. But after you have taken up a diagnostic rubric, you will find only those remedies which are not only homeopathically similar, but are also concentrated on fibroadenoma, which was the major complaint of the patient. Now, case 3. Here, we have a diagnostic rubric and a peculiar general as eliminative. In this case, I have a case of psoriasis. Now the child is 14 years old. We have so many symptoms as skin eruption, psoriasis, itching was in night, the scratching, scratching was basically aggravating the complaint. There was bleeding, the surface was becoming raw. Now there were so many complaints with this patient. I took two basic rubrics. One was psoriasis, that was a diagnostic rubric. Then I took a peculiar general, and the peculiar general was the sleeping position of the child. If a child is sleeping in knee chest position, then obviously it is a very peculiar physical general of the patient. If you are utilizing just these two symptoms as eliminative, the result is shortened to sepia, lyco, silicea, phosphorus, tubuclinum, carcinosin, and lobelia. While previously we had so many remedies in order to choose from which we have to choose the most similar remedy. So if you are utilizing eliminative symptoms like this, for example, if you are choosing a diagnostic rubric and you are using a peculiar general rubric, then the results obtained will be too miraculous and will give result oriented, and this will give you result oriented prescriptions as well. Now case 4, here we have taken a peculiar mental general as an eliminative rubric. I've already told before, if you are using mental generals, you will have to verify them. You'll have to cross verify them from the attendants, from the patient, or in the follow-ups as well. Now, this was a case of non-malignant CA liver. Grade 1 CA liver, it was a squamous cell carcinoma of the patient. We had so many symptoms where appetite was diminished. There was easy satiety after eating. There was discoloration of tongue, right? Now, the patient also had renal calculi. That he was thirstless. He was cachectic. And the major symptom was that there were ailments from being deceived. So whenever you are encountering any such cases where we have a mental general, which is basically ailments from, then that rubric or that mental general completes the whole homeopathic era of the patient. If you are trying to give a prescription homeopathically, you find a mental general, which is ailments from, then in this case or in any of the case, you will get results very much properly. I have taken up just a single rubric, which was ailments from being deceived. And after taking up this, previously I had so many results in the reporterization, and this could have been very confusing as well. But after taking up ailments from as an eliminative, the results shortened up to Lyco, Nux Omega, CPR, Lacasis, Natremur, Pulsatilla. So now it is very much easier to choose from a very short reporterization result rather than from so many remedies which you obtain after reporterization. So this was all for today's session. What I was trying to connect with all of you was very much straightforward, that if you are trying to use elimination method of reporterization, then your selection of rubrics or the selection of your symptoms should be very accurate. You can get back to this presentation in order to make things very much clear to you regarding how to select those symptoms, which symptoms to select from, and how to utilize the elimination method properly in order to get result-oriented prescriptions. So this was all for today's webinar, and I hope I have made myself clear.
Thank you so much, sir. That was indeed very enlightening, and we learned a lot today. I would like to request all our learners to comment in the chat box really quickly so that we can take up a few questions with Dr. Mishra, and we will begin the question answer session in a minute. Also, you can see an option of poll on your chat window. So please send us your reviews on our webinar today. So let's see if we have any questions yet. Okay. Yeah. So, sir, one learner wants you to show how to actually eliminate symptoms in radar.
Okay, just give me a moment. I'm just loading my radar in order to help you all.
Great. So, quickly send us more questions. We have a little time.
Are there any other questions, ma'am, while the radar is booting?
I'm still waiting for the questions, sir. Please send us your questions really fast. So there's a learner who is saying that can we prescribe without eliminating the symptoms?
Obviously, you can prescribe without eliminating symptoms. It is just your choice whether you want to prescribe a result-oriented prescription, or you just want to prescribe on the basis of materia medica, or you want to prescribe on therapeutics. It is basically your choice.
Yes, sir. Okay, still waiting for more questions. Dr. Mishra will soon let you see how to eliminate symptoms. Okay. A learner wants to know, can we use this method in one-sided diseases like mental disorders?
Yes, of course we can use it, but as I told before, if you are having so many mental generals in your case, then you should at least verify all those mental generals again and again, either in the follow-ups or with the people who are accompanying the patient, in order to get the most important mental general out of them all. Then only you will be able to help them.
Yes, sir. Okay, a learner is saying that they have missed the initial part. Well, don't worry. All the registrants of this webinar will receive a mail on their mail IDs from Radar Opus, and they'll get the replay link of this webinar. So you can easily watch it again if you have missed anything.
Now, I have my radar open with me. If somebody wants, I can show them the eliminative method right now.
Yes, sir, please. We can take the rest of the questions after that.
Surely, ma'am. So this is my radar opus. As you can see, I have opened up a case of a patient. I'm removing the symptom right now. Okay. Now, this is the case of an asthma. Now, the child is about 15 years of age. He has been suffering from asthma since past 7 years. So you can easily imagine the patient was basically a small child since he was suffering from asthma. All the symptoms are very much interesting. The first symptom I have taken up is allergic constitution. Most of the times, I usually don't take up this symptom. But when you find a patient where IgE levels are elevated, or where the patient is basically allergic to one thing or the other, then it is very much important to take up this rubric from synthesis repository. Then again, the symptom was asthmatic, the respiration asthmatic children in. Then there was congestion of nose, there was sneezing. Then mental rubrics, the child was obstinate. The anger of the child was really high. You don't find that much anger in children nowadays. But then on the other hand, another important symptom was that the change of weather. Now, if you find that this symptom is very much common, that if a patient is asthmatic or a patient is allergic, obviously he will get, he'll be affected every time whenever there's a change in weather. So this is a common symptom, but you have to take whenever you are reporterizing all these symptoms. Now, while I have taken up this case, the most important symptom which I find in this child was that contradiction, that he had a disposition to contradict everyone. So what I do is I'll take up this symptom as an eliminative symptom. So this is my case. This is my patient's case. I know him well. I have taken up several follow-ups. I have treated him. He is now basically he's really well. He's not suffering from any asthma right now. The major symptom was contradiction, and he had a disposition to contradict others. Another important symptom was that contradiction, he was intolerant. He wants to contradict others every time, but he don't want anyone to contradict him. So I have taken up this symptom because you don't find this mental general in every children nowadays. Now, if you talk about diagnostic symptom, I will take up asthma as a diagnostic symptom in the elimination method. And further, if in case you want to have any other symptoms, for example, here I had a symptom that a child has a habit or had a personal history of having recurrent coryza. So this is another most important symptom in such cases. So I'll take up this too as an eliminative method. Now you see, the patient was allergic, the patient was asthmatic. Now he had a habit of contradicting others. And as a matter of fact, in his personal history, you will find that the patient was having recurrent coryza every time. And this was since childhood, since he was born, since the time he was born, every weather change or every once in 15 days, he used to have coryza. So in this way, if you are utilizing proper diagnostic rubrics along with proper mental generals or some symptoms which are from the history, personal history as well, then you will get this. The reporterization result will be very limited in such cases. Now, again, I'll take up all these symptoms to be normal. I have made these symptoms as normal. As you can see, out of 23 symptoms, we had 566 remedies, which were common to the case. I took up three symptoms as an eliminative, and the result which we got was just 5 remedies out of these 23 symptoms. So basically, choosing the elimination method is your choice. But if in case, I'll close the window. So choosing an eliminative symptom is your choice. But if in case you don't want to utilize elimination method, then you can prescribe therapeutically as well. But if in case you are reporterizing a case, you are basically choosing proper symptoms as eliminative symptoms, then the results of reporterization will be shortened to a very less number of remedies, which will not only be homeopathically similar, but will also give the results.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. A learner wants to know if a particular symptom is very accurate, then can it be taken as an eliminative symptom?
Surely. You can take any symptom which is eliminative. Only point is that you will have to reconfirm it first of all. Then you will have to find out that the medicines mentioned along with the rubrics have authentic sources. The sources are not very much fragile, so in order to get very good results which you want to obtain.
Yes, sir. Can we use physical buildup of a patient as an eliminative symptom?
Now you see, physical buildup always changes. If you are able to see a patient very frequently, or if, for example, if a patient has been under your treatment since past many years, you will be able to see that the physical constitution of the patient changes. So this is a very confusing symptom. So I prefer not to choose this as a eliminative symptom.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Any other questions? We can quickly take up some more questions if you want.
I hope either the session was very boring or I have made my things very much clear to everyone. There can be just two options if we are not getting questions.
Yes, sir. That only our audience can tell us. Quickly, more questions if you want them answered, or else we'll wind up. Okay, I think there. Okay, a question is there. So, should we take hot and chilly symptom, like the thermal reaction, as an eliminative?
Now, you see, thermal reaction, if you just read in the books, you go to the text, you'll find that thermal reactions are always confusing. You need to know what is the actual thermal reaction. He is basically more susceptible to cold, or he more likes cold. So in order to understand the thermal reaction, you need experience. So I prefer not to choose thermals as eliminative. It's better to choose particulars. It's better to choose strict and very strong mentals and very strong physicals along with proper modalities. This will give you proper results.
Yes, sir. I think we have taken up all the questions, sir. Questions related to software, you can visit our website, and or you can contact us on the numbers given to get your answers, get your queries solved. Please send questions for specifically Dr. Chakshu Mishra here, who we have specially here to answer all your questions on this topic. So yes, we have another question. Okay, it's a question that is tendency to take cold is same as recurrent coryza?
Now, recurrent coryza is a complaint, and tendency to catch cold is a basic patient reaction. These are two different things. A person can get recurrent coryza if he's in a situation where there's lots of dust, there are lots of allergens. He can have recurrent coryza every time. So this is a patient reaction. While tendency to catch cold is a patient's original symptom. It is, or if you are having these two symptoms together, it is always advisable to take tendency to take cold as eliminative rather than recurrent coryza.
Okay, thank you, sir. A learner wants to know how to understand the change in genetic makeup.
This is again a very, very long topic. We'll have to have another session anytime.
Another.
I cannot answer this question right now. Now, family history of asthma, can we take up as eliminative? Of course, we can take up. If there is family history of tuberculosis as well, then we can always take up that family history. But If you take up these histories, especially the family history, then maximum medicines which you get are no sorts, and you cannot prescribe no sorts every time. No sorts can be given only as intercurrent remedies in such cases. So it is advisable, if you want to prescribe a no sort, take up the histories as eliminative, you'll get proper no sorts. If you don't want to prescribe intercurrents, you want to give a normal prescription, then you can leave those symptoms.
Thank you, sir. I think all the questions have been taken up. Let's wind up here, if you'll allow me.
Surely.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for such an informative and enriching experience. A very warm gratitude on behalf of Radha Rupees team and on behalf of the PGN group.
Thank you. Thank
also,
you so much.
Also, I apologize if I missed any question. I couldn't take up with Dr. Mishra if I missed any. So sorry for that. Maybe we can take up in some other session. So also to inform all you learners, we have a giveaway right now going on our social media handles. You can take part in the giveaway and win a chance to a free online course on Repertory at a Glance by Dr. Shashikant Tiwari. And you can use this link to participate. So thank you so much. So would you like to say something?
You have mentioned about Dr. Shashikant Tiwari. Sir has been my mentor in my MD. Sir has been my teacher as well, to some extent. He has been my examiner as well. I have learned so many things about repertory from him. So he's a gem in this case, obviously. So really thankful to Radar Opus for organizing a session. I have made myself clear regarding the topic which I took up. And I hope I'll have another session in this regard as well, with some other more interesting topic where the listeners will have more questions to ask from me.
Yes, definitely. We really learned a lot today. Thank you so much. So thank you, everyone. Thank you, dear learners. Thank you, the homeopathic fraternity who joined us here today, and Team Radar Opus, who has been working hard to make this webinar a success. Thank you so much. Good evening, sir. Good evening, everyone.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, everyone.